Hey folks, Machinery Pete here on my travels in Northeast Indiana. We're here to film an auction for our TV show, and my friend Jeremiah Polk here.
Hello.
Jeremiah, great to see you again. Always bouncing into you at auctions around the country, and Jeremiah's with Polk Equipment Incorporated. And Jeremiah told me about a special tractor, folks. We need to learn more about this. This is an early 90s John Deere 2955 with loader. And how many hours on this baby, Jeremiah?
491.
Actual hours.
Actual hours.
Wow. Well, let's get in a little closer, and then we need to hear the story. Now you're gonna be, before we get in too far into the story here, you're gonna sell this tractor next winter on your annual auction. Is that right, Jeremiah?
Yep.
Which is January,
probably
February?
The end of January, 1st of February. It just depends on how the calendar falls.
And that'll be here on the lot in Leesburg, Indiana?
Yep, here on site.
Okay. So this tractor came from a local 90-plus-year-old gal, I understand?
Yep. Her name was Irma Knuckles. Her husband, Ed, bought the tractor brand new.
Okay. Let's walk in a little closer here. So Irma, again, what year? You said it's a 90?
91.
91 model. And did Ed pass away shortly after they
yep.
purchased?
That's what they told me, that Ed passed away very shortly after. And they kept it in the barn because Irma, you know, they still had their farmstead and they still
right.
had plowed snow and some little things like that.
Right. And they were just kind of using it as a general chore tractor, move snow. And then their daughter Jenny also, you were dealing with her?
Yeah.
And you got
so
the tractor?
I dealt with Jenny and Irma. There was a brother also that was the one that's why they kept the tractor, but the brother passed away also.
Oh, sure.
But I dealt with Jenny and Irma. And that's who contacted me when they wanted to sell the tractor, was Jenny. And I got to go meet them both. And
it was just time the tractor needed to find a new home, huh?
Yep.
Okay, well now, Jeremiah, I know you deal, and your dad Tim here, in really high quality used equipment. That's what you guys are known for. What did you, when you heard about this and when you first saw it, what jumped out at you?
The first thing is when you hear about a 2955 with 400 hours, you about jump out of your chair like,
right.
there ain't no way. But
right.
it's like, I want to be a seer. I want to be a believer. And,
right.
You know, but it's just one of the things, just like anything, you can't force the issue.
Right, right.
You just got to, it's on their terms.
Right.
But I was lucky enough, they did contact me and I got to go down and look.
And I understand, as you were describing, in the, just the process of, you know, trying to get the tractor bought, you described what you would do with the tractor, and it involved some intense, just what you normally do to it, but that seemed to strike a chord with Irma?
With Irma, so I told Irma, when I first looked at it, it needed a few things, just
sure.
like any old tractor does. The batteries were dead, it
right.
had it, you know, it had 400 hours, and it had probably the original oil still in it and everything, so,
right.
you know, that's a long time for that stuff to sit. I told her I didn't want to start the tractor if I bought it, I didn't want it started. I wanted to pull
right.
it out of the barn myself.
Right.
And I told her, I said, I got a lot to do with this tractor, Irma. I go, this tractor is A1 unique and special, but I'm going to have to put batteries in it. I'm dumping every fluid out of this thing. I'm
right.
going to bring it home. It's going to get a hot soapy bath. We're going to wash it, wax it, polish it. And she looked at her daughter and said, Jenny, that's the guy I want to have the tractor. I mean, that's the guy.
Right.
So it must have struck something with her
yeah,
just to have the pride cool. and the care of ownership when.
Well, let's walk in a little closer, Jeremiah, now. Show us some of the things that made you smile to find a 27-year-old tractor here with such low hours and like new condition.
Well, I guess the first thing that kind of set it off is if you look at the top of the battery box covers, I mean, there's. And I know this is the, not the door side, but the door side's the same way. It just hasn't been used.
Right.
I mean, you look at the fuel lines, there's all the original paint. I mean, there's no bolt that's ever been took off anywhere. Now, the fuel line here has been replaced because it was cracking.
Sure.
Because that's that molded plastic, and it just got hard and brittle and it was cracking, so we had to replace this fuel line and oil line and stuff. The tires, I mean, the rims were so bright and shiny. I mean, it's just one of a kind. And you look underneath, there's just no rock chips or nothing like that from going down the road too much or anything like that.
And how about the loader up front?
The loader, I mean, you look at the bucket at the front, you look at the pins right through here, there's just no use, no cracking. It's just unreal. And then you look at the bucket, the bucket's Not even been used hardly.
Not one you find every day, huh?
Nah, this is kind of the...
Okay, now we got to tell the rest of the story here, Jeremiah. When you crawled up into the cab the first time, you found something up there, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
All right.
The original operator's manual.
Okay.
And it's still sitting here. And this is what kind of set it off and made it really, really, really neat. So here's the original owner's manual.
Yep.
Here's the original loader owner's manual.
Okay.
But if you open the back page, look at that.
Wow. That's Ed's.
Ed's handwriting.
60 hours on, what is it, July 15th,
1991? Yep, 180 hours in May of 1993. Radiator drained August 20, 1993. And replaced to 35 below zero, 185 hours. New fuel filter, June of 1994.
Wow, very cool.
And then if you look a little bit deeper here, it shows, here it is, where's it at? You know, all like the identification plates and all that.
Yep.
And model 2955, date sold February 21st, 1991 to Ed Knuckles.
Okay. There's some more notations. And what dealership was this? Well, actually, right on the tractor here.
Yeah, on the hood, it's Harper Implement.
Harper Implement Company, is that Swayze? Is that how you guys say that?
Yeah,
here?
Swayze, Indiana. Mm-hmm.
How far is that from Leesburg?
About an hour and 20 minutes.
Okay.
From here.
Very cool. And the cab, overall cab condition, is like you're going back in time up there, Jeremiah?
It's like new.
Nice.
Now, I will say we had to replace the lower end of the cab kit.
Sure.
It was just, and you can start seeing little parts of the 2950 hull just starting to fall down. And this
27 years.
It was starting to deteriorate, and that's what it was. But we tried to keep, like, this is original. But you can see it's falling down a little bit. We didn't want to replace it.
Right, right. And again, just acquired this recently, and you're going to be having it for sale on the auction.
Yeah, I'm not going to sell it till the end of January, 1st of February in our auction. This is kind of the...
Because you know your phone would ring.
I don't want to answer all the phone calls, and this way, everybody has their own unique chance.
Right, and give a lot of folks a chance to get up close to, and see it at the auction. It'll be a great headliner next winter. So, and what have you now? You're as connected as anybody I know. We'll have you pop out of the cab here, Jeremiah. But the used equipment market, this horsepower tractor, well, and this vintage too, good condition is pretty strong, isn't it?
I would say it's pretty strong. It's hard to say, really, Greg, because I don't know what you compare it to. I mean, I don't know if anybody's seen a 2955 last time with 490 hours.
Right.
I think there was a 2,000-hour one sold not too long ago in Martinsville. It brought 30,000 without a loader.
Right.
But that's not even comparison. This is 490 hours.
Right.
So and that was just recently.
Right.
So, but I would say these style of tractors like this, these 55 series, are always very popular.
Right.
I guess it's... Whatever it brings.
We'll find out next January or February. And again, the website, you have all the auction information that'll be posted on your website, Jeremiah.
Yes, it will be.
And PolkEquipmentInc.com.
.com.
And Jeremiah, you, now again, I don't meet too many people that love the equipment business more than you do. You kind of grew up in it, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
With your dad, Tim, here?
Yeah, my grandpa started the business originally with the boys, and I'm sure you guys all know Dennis and Tim, and there was Sally and my late Uncle Gary.
Right.
All started the business just down the road from here, which now is Worthington Salvage.
Yep.
And then from there, it just kind of grew, and we all kind of went our own ways. But yeah, we've always been around the machinery business all our lives.
Well, what do you love most about the business, Jeremiah?
One's the people, and two's the hunt. Finding these like unique tractors like this, you get to meet them kind of people. Just finding that stuff that's just neat, and then getting to connect to the next guy and sell to the next guy and then having the story with him, and that's just great.
There is a story on every piece of equipment, isn't there?
There usually is.
Right.
Sometimes good, sometimes bad.
That's right. Well, Jeremiah, thank you for telling us the story about this sweet 2955. Again, you said a 92?
91.
91. 491 hours?
400, I looked, it was 498. So
498.
Like we put probably 5 or 6 on
us. Okay. Well, you know, I'll be... If I can't make it out to the auction next winter, I'll be needing video of this thing selling, but it should be great fun. Thanks again, Jeremiah.
Thank you.
Ram Trucks, premier vehicle of Machinery Pete TV.